Hi guys, welcome to Lingoni English. My name is Jeff, and despite the beautiful weather outside, I wanted to be here making a video for you on despite and in spite of. Despite and in spite of are phrases to show that something is unexpected or that it doesn't influence your decision when you're making a decision. That sounds really complicated. So let's talk about it in a little bit more detail. Let's say, for example, that it's snowing outside. Now, this may not be true for everybody, but I think for most people, when it's snowing, you don't usually want to go for a run. But maybe you really like running in the snow. So you could say, despite the snow, I want to go for a run. Despite the snow, I want to go for a run. So again, the snow is not affecting your decision. Even though it's snowing, you still want to go for a run. And that may be surprising to most people, that the snow didn't impact your decision to run. And that's the key to despite. It's very similar in meaning to even though. And there's also another way you could phrase it too. You could use In spite of the snow, I wanted to go for a run. In spite of the snow, I wanted to go for a run. You also have some flexibility here with the order. For instance, you could say, I wanted to go for a run despite the snow. Or, I wanted to go for a run in spite of the snow. Either of those sentences is fine. They both work. Now, something you want to keep in mind when you're using despite or in spite of is that they are followed by a noun. You don't need a verb. So again, despite the snow is your noun. Or in spite of the snow, again, the snow is your noun. Let's now practice this a little bit. I'm going to give you a situation and you can help me create a sentence. For example, look at this. The weather was bad. I made it to work on time. So I could say, despite the bad weather, I made it to work on time. Despite the bad weather, I made it to work on time. Or, in spite of the bad weather, I made it to work on time. In spite of the bad weather, I made it to work on time. You can also switch this, right? You could say, I made it to work on time despite the bad weather, or in spite of the bad weather. Either of those can work fine. Let's take a look at another example. There was food in the fridge. We ordered out. There was food in the fridge. We ordered out. I could say, despite the food in the fridge, we ordered out. Or, in spite of the food in the fridge, we ordered out. All this just means that the food in the fridge did not impact our decision to order more food. Another example, there was a piano at home. The boys learned guitar. Again, there's a piano at home. The boys learned guitar. So I could say, despite the piano at home, the boys learned guitar. Or, in spite of the piano at home, the boys learned guitar. So again, having the piano did not affect their decision to learn guitar. One last example. There was a car in the driveway. I took the bus. There was a car in the driveway. I took the bus. So we could say, despite the car in the driveway, I took the bus. Or, in spite of the car in the driveway, I took the bus. The car was there, but it didn't affect our decision to take the bus. One last note about the phrase despite or in spite of. These phrases are often followed by the fact that. It's not necessary to use them, but they're still very commonly heard or seen. For instance, you could say, despite the fact that there was food in the fridge, we ordered out. Or, despite the fact that there was a car in the driveway, I took the bus. The meaning is the same. This is just a common phrase that you may see used with despite or in spite of. Looking for more practice? In the comments, you can write some sentences that use despite, in spite of, despite the fact that, or in spite of the fact that. Thank you so much for watching Lingoni English. We'll see you in our next video.